Graze has done so well because it really keys into what we're all trying to do in life, and it's you're trying to figure out how to get through life and how do you manage your relationship with your partner and your family and work and becoming the best, you know, you that you can be. And I think also it gives a really wonderful sense of hope, and I think we all need that, especially in the times that we're in right now. And I think there's this incredible journey that you get to experience as an audience member of emotion, but it's so well executed with humor. So I think when you don't know how to manage yourself in your day-to-day life, but you get to watch these really interesting, complicated, and also messed up characters, you don't feel so alone.
There's so many reasons. Something that I always come back to is, especially when it started, it was one of, you know, few, if not two or three shows that featured really strong women, all being the leads of it, you know, strong, independent, powerful women. And that's since obviously grown, and we're seeing a big change in the industry. But at the time when it started, it was a pretty big trailblazing show. And I think for a lot of young women growing up, seeing these really successful, powerful women is really inspiring. So that's why I think a large part of the success of the show was due to that. There's a lot of, you know, social and political commentary that we have on the show, and we use the show to talk about really big issues in the world. Current issues. And we got no lack of problems going on in the world today, so we got lots to talk about this season. I think this season, you know, I was saying in another interview as well, you know, from the crew all the way up to the showrunners, everybody is aware that we are at season 15. This is a huge milestone for the show and everyone involved, past and present. And so I think there's a real sense of urgency and care and responsibility that we want to deliver the best season that we've ever had. We want to show the fans and thank the fans for tuning in for this long and really, you know, show up to that milestone and really deliver an incredible season.
I've been asking myself this. I think it's the writing all the way. You know, we all as the cast do our best to just deliver what the writers write on the page. Krista Vernoff, Shonda Rhimes, all the staff are amazing, and their minds, and also the fact that they actually sometimes listen to us and take our ideas, but mainly their minds, this group of brilliant writers who sit in this room and concoct and figure out how to keep this story fresh and relevant and really, sometimes really important. Ultimately, it was Shonda Rhimes wrote this idea 15 years ago that she just knocked it out of the park. And when an idea is that good, it has longevity. It all comes down to the written word on the page, you know, and the fact that we've got it to the point now that our fans are so invested that they forget that these are words written on a page.
This is a long conversation over wine. The short answer would be, I think that Shonda Rhimes and all of the writers create really dynamic characters who are flawed and lovable and broken and resilient. And I think through 15 seasons, we've seen them go through so much that we as audience members, and I'm including myself, we feel like they're our friends. And you don't kind of go, well, I've been friends with this person for 3 seasons, so I'm done. You really get invested in like, well, and then what happened? And did they have kids? Did they get married? Did they get divorced? Like, we love them.